Welcome to Nonprofit Live TV. I'm Larry Brill, and we are coming to you from Austin, Texas, the Convio 2009 Summit. It's a chance for nonprofit organizations, their leaders, to get together for 2 days and talk about some of the issues that are being at the forefront of the things that the nonprofits need to talk about these days. Look at tools and tips and things for doing their job a little bit better. And joining me right now is Paul Clollery. He's the editor-in-chief at Nonprofit Times. And we have Jeff Peters, who is the president and CEO of CDR Fundraising Group. And we want to talk a little bit now, since so much of this conference is about online and online giving and online tracking of the donors and things like that. There's the privacy issues that a lot of people are talking about these days. And maybe, Paul, we'll start with you. What do you see as like the biggest issue when you have to try and balance online giving and online tracking of donors and still being able to market and be successful in raising money and getting donors?
Well, the first thing is to think about is that there are really a couple of different pockets of donors. The more mature donor who really hasn't gotten on to the Facebook and all the other electronic social media, who still receive mail. And the younger generation who are in fact on Facebook and other social media. The problem is, or the challenge is, the older generation probably don't want as much information about themselves out there as the younger folks on the social networks are providing without a second thought. So it's really quite an interesting challenge for the fundraisers to be able to handle both of those pools of donors.
So what did you have, what was the main message you want people to take away from? You had a workshop today, the two of you guys did. What did you want them to come away from?
I wanted the people within the session to come away with the idea that they've got to be asking questions. Every time they turn around, there's another question to be asked. What is the donor thinking? What would the donor think if we did this? What would the donor think if we did that? And it's really important not to find out the hard way.
Well, what do you think that they should really be most concerned about? I mean, this is a real concern for not even nonprofits, but you know, for-profit corporations as well, as they collect data about the people who would be their customers.
Well, privacy is an important issue, but also data security. And I think from a nonprofit organization standpoint, the security of that data and how they use that data is most paramount for the organization. All you need is one slip up and you're toast.
And Jeff, now you have a different perspective because not only are you a fundraising consultant, but you're also a lawyer. What do you think about this issue?
Well, there's a tension that goes on, and the tension is between providing people information that they actually want, which is generally considered very valuable by them and valuable by the organization providing it, and providing information to people that they don't want, which is considered by the recipient spam. And so the real issue is, if we use information about an individual and we know that they're interested, for example, in whales, but they're not interested in agricultural use of water, and we then provide them information about whales because that's their interest, that's the use of behavioral data, perhaps, to an individual in order to give them what they want. And the question then becomes one of, is that a violation of their privacy rights because we know about them that one is interested in agricultural use of water and the other one's interested in whales. I think that one of the things we tried to discuss with the group was the difference between what is legally required, what is ethically a good idea, and what is a best practice. And I think that the idea is that we need to make sure that people are sensitive to the differences. Nonprofits have a right to speak and to be heard, and that's protected by the First Amendment of the Constitution. It's even more protected than commercial free speech. So they have a right to speak even if people don't want to listen. But the real question is, if you're going to make your donors angry, that would not be a good marketing thing to do. So what you have to do is find out the balance. Now, interestingly enough, while you say that there's a great deal of interest in privacy, the fact of the matter is most of the research shows that very few people express concerns about privacy. In the snail mail world, the postal mail world, with organizations that have lists of millions of people, the rate of complaining about their privacy is less than 0.1%. In the email world, mostly the complaints are about spam, information that they receive that they don't want, which some of which could be solved by saying you can't send anything, but other parts of it could be resolved by sending information that they do want.
One of the things that Jeff was talking about before was the fact that, and I think he talked about it really well, was the fact that nonprofits have a right to free speech, and whether they should exercise it or not is a whole other story. But you gave some terrific examples of AIDS advocacy and others where you have to speak up no matter what the potential donor and whatever the potential risk might be. And advocacy is very different than general fundraising.
That's correct.
And how do you reassure the people, though, that you are taking care of the information that they would not want to get out?
That's a hard one. Nonprofits, if they're going to do their job, do have to protect the information by vetting the vendors that they work with, by making sure that the privacy and security rules that the nonprofit has are adhered to by all the people that they contract with. The nonprofit has literally the same liability that a commercial company. If you leave an index box on your floor of your office with the names and social security numbers and credit card numbers of your donors, and somebody breaks into your building at night and gets that information because you failed to secure it, you're just as liable as the company whose computers got hacked. So it is the same responsibility that any company has to protect the data.
All right, so finally, what is the one thing then that the nonprofit should do to protect that information? If you could give them just one tip, what's the one thing they should do?
Probably it would be to make sure that they have gone through all of the vendors that have access to sensitive information and make sure that those vendors are as secure as the nonprofit is with regard to that information. And if they don't have the expertise to do that themselves, there are firms out there that can do that kind of audit to make sure that the nonprofit has adhered to best practices.
And Paul?
Multiple levels of security. You really cannot risk getting your data stolen in any way, shape, or form.
Okay. Paul, Jeff, thank you very much for being with us today.
Thank you.
We're coming to you from the Convio 2009 Summit. And if you want more information about what the workshops are dealing with today and some of the other parts of the interview, you can certainly find those on nonprofitlive.tv. I'm Larry Brill. We'll be back in a while.